let's discuss about valence band and Fermi energy level. We can simply write that electrons in outermost shell of an atom are called valence electrons, which we all know that electrons in the outermost shell participate in valency or bond formation. That's why these electrons in an atom are called valence electrons. And this shell, which is the outermost shell of an atom, is called valence shell. Similarly, when we talk about a solid lattice, we can write in a solid lattice, the topmost band in which electrons are present is called valence band. Or we can say, when atoms combine to form a solid lattice, or atoms are arranged in a solid lattice, all the valence shell of these atoms overlap and modify in form of a valence band. This is the band in a solid lattice in which all electrons participate in contribution of their valency. So, in this situation, we just take an example of sodium. We can write, this is a good example to understand this valence band. Sodium, where atomic number is 11 and the electronic configuration of sodium, we know it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. So, here we can see 1s orbital is completely filled, 2s is completely filled, 2p is filled and this 3s orbital is half filled. Let's have a look on its energy band diagram. It will look like the situation here. This picture shows the band diagram of sodium. Here we can see that this is 1s energy band, 2s, 2p. This is complete 3s energy band and this is 3p energy band. Here you can see that these 2s and 2p bands are completely filled. Here I have shown this shaded zone, which means that electrons are present in the shaded zone only. And here you can see that this 3s band is partially filled, because we know that in this 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, these are completely filled orbital and it is partially filled orbital. So I have just shown the shaded region by just a part zone of this 3s energy band. So here we can see in this situation, this 3s can be regarded as a valence band of sodium atom, because in this band there are some electrons, and whichever electrons are there in this 3s band will participate in bond formation, or these electrons are called valence electron. And the topmost energy of electron in this band, or the maximum energy of electron in this band, is denoted by this arrow, which is the topmost level of this band, which is filled with electrons. So we can say this energy level we term as a specified name, that is Fermi energy level, or Fermi energy level can be defined specifically as the topmost energy level in which electrons are filled in valence band, and it is generally defined at 0 Kelvin temperature, otherwise at room temperature, because of thermal agitation this level is slightly above the actual value. So it is generally defined at 0 Kelvin temperature. Let's write the definition and some facts about this Fermi energy level on the next sheet. Let's define Fermi energy level. About Fermi energy level, we can write that at 0 Kelvin temperature, the topmost energy level up to which electrons are filled in valence band of a lattice is called Fermi energy level. Fermi energy level always exists in the boundaries of valence band, like in a lattice, this is a valence band. And this valence band is partly filled up to this level, or we can say electrons exist in this valence band up to this energy level. Then this topmost energy level up to which electrons are present is called Fermi level or Fermi energy level. We can also write that room temperature, obviously where temperature is more than 0 Kelvin temperature, due to thermal agitation, electrons are in energy level which is above the Fermi level. This is because of extra thermal energy electrons are having due to room temperature. So we can say at 0 Kelvin all energy levels are filled up to Fermi level because electrons are frozen, and at 0 Kelvin temperature no energy or no thermal energy exists in electrons. So these are not allowed to move above Fermi energy level. So we can also write that at 0 Kelvin temperature, electrons exist only up to Fermi level in all bands above this level are empty. And certainly at room temperature, electrons have some thermal agitation. So this level slightly increases above Fermi level, and Fermi level is just defined only at 0 Kelvin temperature. So we can say at normal room temperature, this level is slightly increased, or at 0 Kelvin temperature, whatever Fermi level exists, electrons are slightly above this level. So always be careful about the analysis of Fermi level and the fact that it is defined at 0 Kelvin temperature only.